President Marcos orders the Education Department to continue efforts to improve the country's performance in the Program for International Student Assessment, or PISA. The president wants the agency to focus on improving the teaching quality and competency, especially when it comes to utilizing technology. He also wants to provide better nutrition to students and address campus bullying. The 2023 PISA results released in December showed Filipino students remain among the world's weakest in math, reading, and science. Corporate stories now. RCBC raises $400 million from its senior unsecured sustainability notes. The lender says this was carried out on Wednesday via a drawdown under its $3 billion medium-term note program. Proceeds of the undertaking will be used to support or finance its loans to consumers or its own operating activities. Meanwhile, Andrew Tan's Mega World set to build its second hotel in Palawan Province. The property giant's Paragua Sands Hotel will rise on a 462-hectare land in San Vicente. The 10-story building will offer 313 guest rooms and will boast a 5-minute walk to the beach and a nearby reserve park. It's set for completion in 2029. No word yet, though, on its cost. As for Enrique Razon's ICTSI, it's eyeing to reduce to zero its greenhouse gas emissions by 2050. The firm says the goal aims to align its business strategy with the United Nations Climate Change Paris Agreement. And finally, telco giant Globe is expanding its use of artificial intelligence. It sees the move as improving customer experience and operational efficiency across its businesses. The Philippine Economic Zone Authority, or PEZA, vows to sustain the growth momentum of foreign investments into the country. PEZA Director General Teresa Panga told ANC's Market Edge. His team is now in Las Vegas in the U.S. to attract potential investors at the Consumer Electronics Show happening there. He hopes this year the Philippines will be able to return to investment levels seen in 2012 to 2015.
For this year, we're eyeing actually a 200 to 250 billion in investments coming from a high investment approvals last year. We've been trying to diversify our export products and investments. So while we anticipate a flat growth in electronics, we're looking at EEV as a strong potential for investments as well as exports, including agriculture. And of course, the bullish growth of the IT industry, still eyeing a 10 to 15% growth. And so we will be more aggressive in promoting the Philippines to global investors.
The Philippine economy, seen by the World Bank as among Southeast Asia's fastest growing this year. The World Bank, in a new report, kept its 5.8% 2024 growth forecast for the country, along with Cambodia. This is higher than its outlook for Vietnam and Indonesia. But the projection is below the government's target range of 6.5 to 7.5% growth. The Philippines' economy grew by 5.9% in the third quarter of last year. Now, region-wise, the World Bank is expecting weak economic expansion, mainly from the slowdown in China. It also warns extreme weather events from climate change could dampen outlook in the region.
Google also set to lay off employees. The firm said it will let go of hundreds of people working on its voice-activated Google Assistant software. It is also eliminating a similar number of roles in the firm's devices and services team. This move is part of organizational changes that have been in place since the second half of 2023, which included layoffs at the company's mapping app Waze. Google did not specify the number of roles being impacted, and it is not immediately clear how many people are part of the Google Assistant software and devices and services teams. Amazon set for another round of job cuts in its streaming and studio operations. Several hundred employees at Prime Video and Amazon MGM Studios will be affected by the move. The decision is part of Amazon's effort to reprioritize its resources, focusing on content and product initiatives. The online retail giant last year cut more than 27,000 jobs as part of a wave of U.S. tech layoffs after the industry hired heavily during the pandemic. Social media giant X has shed more than 1,000 staff globally from teams responsible for stopping abusive content online. That's according to Australia's online watchdog, the eSafety Commission. It said these deep cuts that happened after Elon Musk's takeover, as well as the reinstatement of thousands of banned accounts, had created a perfect storm for the spread of harmful content. The Australian regulator has previously said Musk's takeover of X coincided with a spike in toxicity and hate on the platform. Australia spearheaded the global push for regulation of social media, forcing tech companies to outline how they are tackling issues such as hate speech and child sexual abuse.